feelings. I hear you. I share your goodness with the world. Then how I see and how I experience and how I think about the world changes. Yes, there are lots of bad things happening in the world. Yes, it is easy for us to give up. But Jesus says, I will send the Advocate, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. I will send it to you. And the Spirit will teach you everything you need to know. But as Bob and Julie and Brenda and other teachers here know, you can have all the knowledge in the world, but if the student won't hear it, Julie, you teach piano. Do you know if your student has practiced that week? Absolutely. You see, the Spirit knows when we're practicing. The Spirit knows when we're paying attention to the prompting of God. God knows this. And now that we know it, we can be attentive to not just the hymns, not just the prayers, not just the fellowship, but we can be attentive to all creation, because that's where God is at work, waiting for us to say, here I am. Teach me. Live within me so that I might live within you. And we do that. Then as John used to say to his lay preachers, set yourself on fire for God, and the world will come to see you burn. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
life. You graciously speak your word of hope in times of struggle and uncertainty, and in times of joy and peace. We are grateful that you are continually at work in our lives and the world to tell your good news. Help us to respond in faith and go where you lead us each day. We dedicate our gifts so that our community will draw closer to you. Amen.
With much happening in the world this week, we come with our time of prayer. We lift up the recent shooting in Texas for those families who grieve this day. And also, we lift up those affected by the bombings in Indonesia this past week. There is so much violence in our world that we sometimes think, well, it can't happen here. But we know that that is not the case. So for those who suffer and those who grieve this day, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.